हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज सैफुल इस्लाम, लेक्चरर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, माइलस्टोन कॉलेज। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू माय ऑनलाइन क्लास अगेन। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सरसाइज 8.3 ऑफ योर हायर मैथ। ऑलरेडी वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टू क्लासेस अबाउट दिस एक्सरसाइज, सो टुडे इज द थर्ड क्लास ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द लास्ट टू क्रिएटिव क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज। सो लेट स्टार्ट आवर क्लास। नंबर 14, रेडियस ऑफ अर्थ इज 6,440 किलोमीटर। ढाका एंड पंचकूला मेक्स 3.5 डिग्री एंगल एट द सेंटर ऑफ द अर्थ। अ पर्सन वांट्स टू एंजॉय द सीनिक नेचुरल ब्यूटी ऑफ पंचकूला विथ अ व्हीकल हैविंग अ व्हील ऑफ डायमीटर 0.84 मीटर। दिस आर द गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन। फ्रॉम दिस इंफॉर्मेशन वी विल सॉल्व थ्री क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन नंबर ए, व्हाट इज द एंगल इन रेडियंस ढाका एंड पंचकूला मेक्स एट द सेंटर ऑफ द अर्थ। लुक एट द क्वेश्चन अगेन। ऑलरेडी इट हैज गिवन द इंफॉर्मेशन, ढाका एंड पंचकूला मेक्स 3.5 डिग्री एंगल एट द सेंटर ऑफ द अर्थ। इट इज गिवन एट डिग्री एंड वी विल कन्वर्ट इट इनटू रेडियंट। नाउ लुक एट द बोर्ड। Given Dhaka and Panchagar makes 3.5 degree at the center of the earth. So now we know 1 degree is equal to 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian. Now we have 3.5 degree, so 3.5 degree will be 3.5 into pi by 180 radiant, that is 3.5 into 3.1416 by 180 radian. Now if you calculate it, you will get 0.06 10. So this is the answer of question number A. Radiant. So this is the answer of question number A. Now look, question number B. What is the distance between Dhaka and Panchkula? We will find out the distance of Dhaka and Panchkula. Say this is the earth. This is the earth and this is the center, the radius of the earth, and say this is Dhaka and this is Panchkula. And it produced 3.5 degree angle at the center of the earth. Now we will find out the distance from Dhaka to Panchkula. That means we will find out this length of this arc. We will find out the length of this arc, and we know the formula of arc, that is S is equal to R theta. This is the R and this is theta. Given the radius of earth is equal to 6,440 kilometer, the angle theta is equal to 0.06108 रेडियन. लेट द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ढाका टू पंचगढ़ बी एस. वी नो एस इज इक्वल टू आर थीटा, दैट इज 6440 इंटू 0.6108. सो किलोमीटर, इट विल बी किलोमीटर. इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई दिस इट विल बी 393.398 किलोमीटर. सो दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ बी. दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ बी. Look at the C number question. How many revolutions will the wheel makes while traveling to Panchgarh and Dhaka? So you will go to the Panchgarh to Dhaka to Panchgarh and Panchgarh to Dhaka. From A we get, from B we get, we get the distance from Dhaka to Panchgarh is equal to 393.398 kilometer. Total distance the vehicle travel total distance it will be double by multiplying 2 we will get 786.796 kilometer. So this is the total distance the wheel travel. We convert it into meter. 786.796 into 1000 meter. Why we convert it into meter? Because it is given the diameter of the wheel is meter. The diameter of the wheel is given meter, so we convert the distance into meter. It becomes 786.796 meter. So this is the total distance the wheel travel. Now we will find out the circumference of the wheel. Now we will find out the circumference of the wheel. We know the circumference of the wheel, that is circle, is 2 pi r. Given diameter of the wheel is 0.84 meter. Therefore, radius of the wheel r equal to 0.42 meter. We know the circumference of a wheel is equal to 2 pi r. That is 2 into 3.1416 into 0.42 meter unit. If you multiply this three number, it will be 2.639 meter. So this is the circumference of the wheel. That means If wheel revolve one time, it will go 2.639 meter. If wheel revolve one time, it will pass 2.639 meter. Now total. Number of revolutions, that is total distance divided by the circumference of the wheel. Total 393.398 meter divided by 2.639 times. So after division we will get the answer, that is 2.981.41.72 times. So what is our answer? Our answer is 2.981.41.72 times. This is the answer of C number question. Now problem number 15. Look at the board. It is given a circular wheel ABC where the radius OB is equal to AC square plus 1 and AB arc is equal to 25 centimeter and the perpendicular distance from the point B to the diameter AC is AC square minus 1. Now question number A, in figure ABC is a circular wheel and length of the arc AB is 25 centimeter. Find the value of theta. What distance will the wheel cover in a single rotation? There is two question. At first we will find out the value of theta. Find out the value of theta. And second question is, what distance will the wheel cover in a single rotation? So let's start the solution. Given arc AB equal to S equal to 25 centimeter, radius OB equal to R equal to S square plus 1. We know S equal to R theta. Therefore, theta equal to S by R, that is 25 by S square plus 1 radian. Always keep it in your mind, the theta of here, theta is always radian. Theta is always radian. So this is the value of first part. Now the second part, what distance will the wheel cover in a single rotation? I mean, if it rotated one time, how many distance it will cover? That means the circumference of the wheel in one time, how many distance it will be covered, that will be the circumference of the wheel. So we will find out the circumference of the wheel. Again, we know circumference of the circular wheel is 2πr. 2πr means S square plus 1 centimeter. So this is the answer of second part. Now question number B. What is the speed of the wheel ABC if it revolves 5 times in a second? In 1 second it rotates 5 times. Already we have find out in A number question how many distance it covers in a single rotation. So if it covers in a single rotation 2 pi x square plus 1, how many distance it covers in 5 times? We will find out it at first. From A we get, in one rotation the will cover 2 pi s square plus 1 centimeter. Therefore, in 5 rotation, the will cover 5 into 2 pi s square plus 1 centimeter. That is 10 pi s square plus 1 centimeter. This distance it covered in a second. Now, what is the speed? We know speed is the distance covered within a hour. The total distance covered in a hour. Then that distance should be in kilometer. So, the speed of the wheel is equal to 10 pi s square plus 1 into 60 into 60 divided by 100 into 1000 kilometer per hour. The unit of the distance is kilometer per hour. How many kilometer is travel in a hour? That one is the speed of that wheel. It is centimeter. To convert it into kilometer, we should multiply, we should divide 100 by 100 into 1000. If you divide by 100, it will be meter. Then if you divide by 1000, it will be kilometer. Now, why you multiply 60 into 60? This is in a second. It's travel in a second. If you convert it into hour, you should multiply 60 into 60. If you multiply by 60, it will be minute. And after that, if you multiply 60 again, it will be hour. Now, cancel it. 6, 10, 10, 10, 100, 6. So, what it become? It become 36 pi s square plus 1. By 100, that is 0.36 pi s square plus 1 kilometer per hour. So this is the answer. This is the speed of the wheel in kilometer per hour. Now question number C. In the figure, find the value of sine theta from triangle BOD. From this triangle, we will find out the value of sine theta. And to prove that, tan theta plus sec theta equal to x. Now, look at the board. In the right angle, triangle BOD, sine theta equal to what? Look, sine theta is equal to the opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side is s square minus 1 and hypotenuse is s square plus 1. So, what it will be? S square minus 1 by s square plus 1. This is the value of sine theta from the triangle BOD. Now, look at the board again. We will prove that tan theta plus sec theta equal to x. If you want to prove that tan theta plus sec theta equal to x, you need to find out the value of cos theta. We know cos square theta equal to 1 minus sin square theta. That is 1 minus s square minus 1 by s square plus 1 whole square. That is 1 minus s square minus 1 whole square by s square plus 1 whole square. That is s square plus 1 whole square
एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन होल स्क्वायर माइनस एस स्क्वायर माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर।
लुक एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन होल स्क्वायर माइनस एस स्क्वायर माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर दैट इज ए प्लस बी होल स्क्वायर माइनस ए माइनस बी होल स्क्वायर। दिस इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ फोर ए बी। फोर ए ए मीन्स एस स्क्वायर एंड बी मीन्स वन, सो नो नीड टू राइट अबाउट देयर वन। देन एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन होल स्क्वायर, सो दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस स्क्वायर। बट वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस थीटा। देयरफॉर कॉस थीटा इक्वल टू टू एक्स बाई एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन। इफ यू डू द स्क्वायर रूट ओवर देयर इट विल बी टू एक्स बाई एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन बिकॉज दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा। सो कॉस थीटा विल बी टू एक्स बाई एस स्क्वायर प्लस वन। सो बाई यूजिंग दिस टू इन्फॉर्मेशन we will prove that tan theta plus sec theta is equal to 1. Now, left hand side, tan theta plus sec theta. We know tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. And sec theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. So we can write cos theta sin theta plus 1. So what is the value of sin theta? Just now we have written that sin theta is equal to s square minus 1 by s square plus 1 plus 1. And the value of the cos theta is 2x by s square plus 1. That is s square plus 1 s square minus 1 plus s square plus 1 and this is 2x by s square plus 1. Now calculate it. It will be 2s square by s square plus 1, and if I give multiplication sign over there it will be reciprocal s square plus 1 by 2x. Cancel this 2 and s square divided by x that is x. So look, this is the right hand side. So we can write over there right hand side proved. So my dear student, hope that you have understood. Practice this math again and again. See you again. Allah Hafiz.